we'll be starting with the hexahedron problem. The problem states like this: a hexahedron and cube both are same. Okay. So a hexahedron of side, how much? 30 mm. So each and every side of this hexahedron which he has given you, the cube is 30 mm. Okay. And what he is telling is, it is resting on one of its corners. Okay, it is corner resting. Okay, on HP it is resting on corners, such that one of its solid diagonal, please read this word properly, okay, one of its solid diagonal, see, I'm keeping the solid like this is a solid hexahedron, okay, if it is a edge resting, you can see like this, okay, in this problem he is telling you to keep it in the corner resting. That means the corner resting will be like this. So when you look from the top view, so it will be like this, fine. In the front view, you can see it is resting with respect to the corner. The front view will be like this. And the stick which I have placed, the stick is nothing but your solid diagonal. Fine. What he is telling, first you place it with respect to the corner on HP. Okay, this will be a front view, first condition. Okay, if you take the top view, what will be your top view? The top view will be like this. Fine, this is your top view. And in the first condition, and the front view will be like this. Okay, this is your front view. And second condition, what he has given is very important. Okay, so we'll go read that problem. Okay, such that one of its solids diagonal, the stick which you can see is your solids diagonal, is perpendicular to VP. That means, see, whatever you can see this wall is your vertical plane. Okay, I have to make this stick perpendicular to your VP. How do I do that? So this is very important. What I'll be doing is, so first I'll keep the solid like this. This will be a front view of it. Okay, then what I'll do is, I'll rotate the solid like this. With respect to one of the corner, I'll rotate. Now, can you see this stick is parallel to your horizontal plane? This is your horizontal plane. With respect to this horizontal plane, the stick is horizontal. That is nothing but your diagonal. But what he is telling in the problem, the solid's diagonal should be perpendicular to your VP. Now, how should I rotate? How should I rotate the object so that the stick will become perpendicular to your VP? Now, what I'll do is, I'll rotate the object like this. I'll start rotating the object like this. Okay, you can observe. You can observe carefully. Yeah, now. If I place like this, don't you think the stick which you are able to see in the front view is perpendicular to your vertical plane? Yes, this is your final view. This is your final answer. Okay, the second condition in this problem is not given to you. Okay, what you're supposed to do is, first you place the object like this with respect to one of the corner. With respect to one of the corner. See, both the sides, it will be a corner only. Fine, then what I will do is, one of the solids diagonal should become perpendicular to VP is your question. So what I'll be doing, this solid's diagonal, this stick is your diagonal. This stick, what I'll be doing is, first I'll make it parallel to your HP. Okay, first I'll make it parallel to your HP. Now it is parallel, right? Then after that, making it parallel, I will rotate in such a way that it will become perpendicular. See, now I'll rotate like this. Perpendicular in the sense, you won't be able to see the solid diagonal. You won't be able to see the stick. This is the third condition. The third condition he has given you in this problem. You can see the second condition is a question mark. That means you're supposed to find out the second condition. Okay. The third condition is the diagonal will be perpendicular to VP. This is your third condition. Okay. That is your third condition. So how do you draw that? Again, I'll repeat it. The first condition, you'll keep the object like this, okay, with respect to one of the corner, and the stick is your diagonal, solid diagonal. This will be a front view. What will be your top view? The top view will be like this. Okay, this is your top view. Then, the second condition, what I'll be doing, which is not given to you, what I'll do is, okay, the solid's diagonal, I'll make it parallel to HP. First, I'll make it parallel like this. When I make it parallel like this, so what will be your top view? The top view will be like this. When you look from the top, this is what you can see. Okay, again, the third condition, you have to make this diagonal, okay, the solid diagonal, you have to make the solid diagonal perpendicular to your VP. That means I'll rotate the object like this so that your stick will become perpendicular to your vertical plane. This is the third condition. In this third condition, when you look from the top, so when you observe from the top, it looks like this. This is your top view and this will be your front view in the third condition. Okay, I'll draw this and I'll show you. Okay, first thing, we have to keep the object with respect to corner resting. Okay, this will be your first condition. I'll draw the top and front view. Fine, we'll draw the XY line first. We'll draw the first XY line. Okay. So this will be your X, Y, VP, HP. In the vertical plane, you can see the front view. In the horizontal plane, you can see the top view. Now I am drawing the top view. This is my top view. A corner resting cube or a corner resting hexahedron. Okay. How do I draw the top view? So you fix at any one particular point. Okay, fix a particular point. Keep your protractor. What is the angle you're supposed to take? 45 degrees on either side. 45 degrees this side, again 45 degrees on the other side. Fine. From this point, join it. Join it. Okay. What is the side of the cube? The side of the cube he has given you as how much? 30. Take three boxes length. Take three boxes length. Okay. And cut an arc. Okay. The same thing from one of the corner, cut an arc. Okay, so you will be getting the top view of the hexahedron. The first condition. First condition is given. Okay. Fine. It's done. The first condition is done. We have placed a hexahedron on HP with respect to another corner. When you look from the top, you can see this square. Okay, that is what we have drawn here. Okay. Fine. Then how do you mark the points? Marking the points. Let this be A, B, C, and D. If this is A, what will be this point? A1. If this is B, this point will be B1, C, C1, D, and D1. Okay. And again, in the midpoint, we have O1. That is your axis. That is your axis. So let this be the point A1. This is your point B1, C1, D1. Okay, and show the dimensions also. Extend the dimensions extension line. Okay, and this will be how much? This will be 30. Fine. Then next. You're supposed to show the axis also. Show the axis also. Okay. So this will be a point O1. The top view is done. This is your top view. Now what about the front view? The front view, I'll show it like this. This is your front view. You can see 1, 2, 3 longer edges. The front view, I'll draw it here. Okay. It will be here like this. Okay. 1, 2, 3 longer edges is visible for the observer. What is the height? It is again the same 30 mm. So from the midpoint, from the axis, extend a line. That is a thin line. Okay. From here, again, the height is how much? 30. Three boxes. Again, from one of the corner, one more corner, we'll be raising the height. Okay. Again, this is also height of how much? 30. Again, from the corner C, extend the line, thin line. Again, from that, extend a thick line. So this is your front view of the hexahedron. First condition is done. Okay, this is your front view. It looks like this. Okay. Now, we will draw the diagonal. First, we'll draw the diagonal. I will mark the points. Then we'll draw the diagonal. Okay, the height which is given to you is how much? The height is given to you is how much? 30. So this will be your 30 mm height. We'll mark these points. Okay, how do you mark the points? If you want to mark the points, the observer will be looking from this side. Okay, for the observer, which all the edges are which visible? This is A, this is D, and this is C. Behind we have the point B, which is not visible for the observer. Okay, so which will also be this point? This will be my point A dash and A one dash. What about this point? This will be D dash, D one dash. What about this edge? It is C dash, C one dash. Again, behind this we have the axis, that is O dash, O one dash. Again behind that, so like it is like this. This is the point D. Okay. Again behind that we have one more edge which is not visible for the observer. That is B dash, which is in bracket, B one dash in bracket. Fine. Okay. Done. Now, what I'll be doing is I'll be drawing the diagonal. Okay. Instead of taking this diagonal, what I'll do is I'll show the diagonal like this. Even this is also a diagonal. Okay. Any one diagonal we'll take. Okay. So this diagonal. So this diagonal again, I'll make it horizontal like this. Then we'll make it perpendicular like this. Okay. So what I'll be doing is A dash to C one dash is the diagonal, solid diagonal. Make it thin, draw it thin. Okay, it is like this. Fine. This is your front view. I'll take this stick. Okay, this is your diagonal, solid's diagonal, which I have drawn here. Okay, from A dash to C one dash, which I have drawn. Okay. Now, what I'm supposed to do in the second condition is, okay, in the second condition, what I'm supposed to do, which is not given to you in the problem. What I would do is first this diagonal, which is this stick, I have to make it parallel. Okay, so it was like this. Then I have to make it parallel. After making it parallel to your HP, that is your XY line, then we will make it perpendicular, which is the third condition given to you. How do you make A dash to C dash parallel here? Okay, observe the construction lines. Observe the construction lines. How do we make parallel? Okay. Now, from the point A1 dash to B dash. I'm repeating, from the point A1 dash to B dash, you draw one more line. This is a construction line. Okay, this is a construction line which will help us to make this, draw this parallel. Okay, which will help us to make the diagonal A dash to C1 dash parallel to your XY line. Fine. Now what I'll do? I'll fix the point A1 dash. This is the point A1 dash which I have fixed. I'll measure, then you draw a vertical line. Draw a vertical line. Okay, that is A1 dash to B dash, D dash, O dash. It is a construction line. Remember, I'll measure from A1 dash to D dash, A1 dash to D dash. Okay, A1 dash to D dash. We'll cut an arc. Okay, which is this point? B dash, D dash, O dash. Why I am drawing this perpendicular? So that the point A dash to C one dash will become horizontal. That is the second condition which we are supposed to do, which is not given in the problem. You can observe this. When you draw this line, this will be perpendicular. Okay, this will be perpendicular. Now what you have drawn, that is the construction line A1 dash, the construction line A1 dash to B dash, O dash, D dash, B dash, D dash, O dash, we have drawn. It should be perpendicular. Now, what I'll be doing is mark this point as X. Okay, the intersection point which you can see here, mark this as X. Okay. I'll mark this point as X. Fine. Measure from A1 dash to X. Measure from A1 dash to X and cut an arc. So this is your point what? X. I'm repeating it. First, what I have done is I've taken the length from A1 dash to B dash, D dash. I've drawn a perpendicular line. Again, the point X, I have marked it here. At the point X, what you'll be doing is you'll be drawing a horizontal line. At the point X, you'll be drawing a horizontal line. Fine? So on this line, you will get the point A dash. Again, on the same line, you'll be getting the point C1 dash. You're understanding? Okay. So on the same line, you'll be getting A dash and C1 dash. Measure X to A dash. Measure X to A dash. Okay, this will be a point A dash. Again, similarly, measure from X to C1 dash. Okay, X to C1 dash. So this will be a point C1 dash. What we have done? See, first thing, we had the axis like this. So we had the So first thing, what we have done is we have kept it with respect to the corner. See, this was your first condition. Second thing, what I am doing is the diagonal, I have to make it parallel. See, this is your point, which one? A dash. A dash is, this is your point A dash. Okay. And this is your point C1 dash. Okay. I am making the diagonal parallel. First, I'll make the diagonal parallel. Can you see? A dash to C1 dash. A dash to C1 dash. Okay. I made this parallel. So that is your second condition. Okay, first we'll make it parallel. Then in the last condition, we'll make it perpendicular. Okay. So now what you have done? So we have this point A dash to C1 dash. Fine. Join it. Okay. So join it. And complete this box. Complete the rectangle box. How do you complete the rectangle box? We have this L shape, okay, this L length we have. Similarly, you take the measurement, okay, from A1 dash to A dash, from A1 dash to A dash, you cut an arc, okay. Again, you take the another diagonal length, you take the another diagonal length, okay, and cut an arc here. Or what you can do is, very simple, at the point C, okay, you can draw a perpendicular line. At the point C, just draw a perpendicular line. That's it. Okay, again from the point A to C1 dash, you draw one more perpendicular line. See, what I have done is this rectangular box I have rotated like this. Fine, that's it. Okay, now we'll draw the top view. Fine. So extend the base projections. Extend the base projections. Now we'll start with the top. We'll start joining A dash with the A. Extend A dash with the A. So this will be your point A. Again, start joining from B dash. B dash. To when you start joining, dropping a line from B dash, you'll be getting the B dash here. This will be a point B. Again, D is coming on the same line. Here you have the point D. Again, O is coming on the same line. This will be a point O. Fine. Again, we'll come start drawing the line from C dash. Okay. So this will be a point C dash. Okay. We got A, B, C. Sorry, it is just C because it is in the top view. After that, what do you do? Join this. Join this A to B, B to C, C to D, and D to A. Fine? Okay. The next, we'll start dropping the line from the base. Okay, we have started dropping a line from A dash, B dash, C dash, and D dash. Okay, that is your top. So A, we have marked it B, C, and D. Now, come to the base. See, this is your base. This portion is your base. So again, you'll start joining from A dash, to the base of the A dash. Okay. So when you start joining, dropping a line from here, see, this will get coincided. The point A1 will come here only. See, the point A is coming from the front view. So in the top view, it is coinciding here only. Okay. Then B, start joining from the point B. Okay. So when you start joining from the B, so this point here you'll be getting, so the point B will be here. So B1 is coming from here. This will be your B1. Okay. Similarly, again, the point C dash is coming from top. Okay. So this will be your point C. Fine. So this will be a point B and this will be a point C1. And when it comes down, okay, and this will be a point D. And finally, the last one, that is your this point C. Project the point C also. So this will be a point. Already we have done C1. So this is your base. So this won't be C1. So this is your C1. This is your C. Okay, and there will be another point called as, this is your O1, which will be in bracket. So, okay, I'll repeat this. Fine. After drawing this one, okay, after drawing the front view, what you do is, okay, you just concentrate on the top. Okay, I'll extend the A dash, B dash, C dash, and D dash of the top with A, B, C, D. Okay, the point A dash will be coming from here. So, the point A is coming from here, it will coincide here. After that, B dash, extend the point B dash. Okay, when you extend the point B dash, coincide with the point B. Similarly, the point D dash, you extend it, okay, and you start coinciding with the point D. Again, in the same line, we have the axis, that is O dash will be coming, okay, in the same line, we have the point O also. After that, you just join this, finish it, okay, then we'll go with the base, that is A1 dash, B1 dash, C1 dash, D1 dash, and O1 dash will coincide with the base. So we'll start with the point A1 dash. The point, this is your point A1 dash. The A1 dash is coming from the front view. Okay. And it will get coincide with the A1. And this is the same point as O. Okay. This will be your A1. A1 and O will be same point. After that, A1 is over. We'll go with the B1. This is your point B1. Dash, okay, extend the point B1 dash. Okay, the point B1 is coming from here, so this will be a coinciding point B1. After that, again come to C1, extend the point C1 of the base, just concentrate only on the base. C1 dash of the base, okay, again C1 from the top view is coming from here, this will be your C1. After that, again come for D, so this is your D1 dash. Okay, this is D1 dash. Again, D1 dash is coming from the front view. Again, D. Where is your D? Here. Yeah. Here, D1 is coming from here. Finally, this point will be your T1. Okay, please do this very carefully. Okay, and finally, the axis O1 dash. This one is the O1 dash. The O1 dash is coming from here. Okay, here we have O1. So again, the point C and the point O1 both will get coincide. Now, what will we do? Which will be the hidden lines? First, what I'll be doing is the longer edges. Okay. Remember the longer edges. Which are the longer edges? A to A1, B to B1, C to C1, D to D1. Okay. The object is rotated like this. Okay. In the top view, I'll be showing you. The object was like this. This is A, B, C, and D. Okay. Then what I have done is I have rotated the object like this. When it rotated the object like this, hang on. So this here, yeah, it was like this. The object is rotated like this. Okay, so that this diagonal, I am making it parallel. This is your second condition top view. In this case, second condition top view, what all you can see? You can see this top face, which we have made it thick, A, B, C, D. Have you made it thick? Yes. Then can you see this edge? Yes. 1, 2, 3. These three edges you can see. Can you see two base? That is 1 and this 2. Two bases are visible. Which is the point which is not visible? It is in the bottom. 1, 2, 3. Three edges will not be visible for the observer from the top view. Okay. So first, what I have done is, after rotating the object like this, I have rotated the object like this. This is your second condition, top view. This portion is visible. That is why we have made it thick. 1, 2, and 3. Okay. Three longer edges. That is B to B1, C to C1, D to D1. B to B1, C to C1, D to D1. What about A to A1? What will happen to A to A1? A to A1 will become dotted. This is A to A1. Okay, then we'll start joining the base. That is A1, B1, C1, and D1. A1, B1, C1, D1 is the base of this hexahedron. What will happen to that? Okay. I'll start joining from B to D1 to C1. It is passing outside. Again, I'll start joining from C1 to D1. It is passing outside. So when I start joining from D1 to A1, when I start joining from D1 to A1, what will happen? It will cut this edge. Then what will happen to that? It will become dotted. When I start joining from A1 to B1, okay, that is A1, B1, C1, D1 is a base. When I start joining from A1 to B1, again, this will cut this edge. It will become what? Dotted. Okay, there will be three hidden lines. Okay, it is like this. The first condition was like this. Second condition, you rotate like this. Okay, when you rotate it like this, in the top view, this was the top which is visible for the observer, which we made thick. Okay, after that, 1, 2, and 3 are the longer edges. That is D to B1, C to C1, D to D1, we are drawn. Again, these are the base. These two bases, that is B1 to C, B1 to C1, C1 to D1 is visible. But this one, can you see this point? See, this is the corner on which it is resting. 1, 2, 3 lines are not visible for the observer. That is why these are hidden and dotted. Okay. Now, the last condition, what he is telling is, okay, you have to make this diagonal perpendicular to your what? Vertical plane. Which is your diagonal in this case? The diagonal which we are shown is from A to C is your diagonal in the front view. What about in the top view? Where is your diagonal? This is your A to C1 is your diagonal. With respect to XY line, A to C1 is parallel. With respect to XY line, A to C1 is your parallel. Now what we'll do is, we'll rotate this object. Okay, we'll rotate this object in such a way that A to C1 will become perpendicular. I'm repeating this. Okay, so we have kept the object like this. We'll rotate the object in such a way that, okay, the stick is your diagonal. That is A to C1. A to C1 is a diagonal. The A to C1, what I'll make it as, I'll make this as perpendicular to your vertical plane. So when I rotate it in a perpendicular vertical plane, obviously the diagonal will also be perpendicular to your wall. Okay, that we'll show in the front view. Third condition, top view, what we are doing is, we are just rotating this object in such a way that A and C will become perpendicular. For that, it is very simple. You just draw one straight line. Draw a straight line. First, mark the point C. So at any particular point, let this be C1. Okay. On the same line, okay, you can see. Measure from C to O1. Okay, C to O1. So this will be your O1. Again, similarly, measure from C1 to A1. C1 to A1. This will be your A1. Again, similarly, measure from C1 to A. C1 to A. So this is your A. See here, this line from the point C1 to A, the from the point C1 to A, O1, A1, O. Okay, because these two will get in, will be in the same point. Okay, A1 and O will be in the same point. Okay, I've drawn this. Then we'll just complete the other points. What I'll be doing is, I'll measure from the point C1 to B1. I'll measure from C1 to B1. C1 to B1 and C1 to D1, both will be same. C1 to B1, cut an arc. Okay. Again, A1 to B1. A1 to B1. So this will be a point B1. I have taken from C1 to B1. Okay, again, A1 to B1. I'll get the point here. Similarly, D will be getting this side. Okay. C1 to D1, cut an arc. A1 to D1, cut an arc. So this is your point D1. Okay. Similarly, the other two points also, B and D. This length will be same. What I'll be doing is O1 to B, O1 to D. So that is O1 to D, A to D. O1 to B, A to B. So this will be a point B and this will be a point D. Okay. Then complete this. The same object I have rotated in such a way that the point C1 to A will become perpendicular to your XY line. Okay. We'll complete this. Join. So this point, again, this point will be C. We forgot to mark it. Okay. This one, A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D, I have joined. Okay. Then the longer edges, B to B1, D to D1, C to C1. Okay. Again, B1 to C1, C1 to D1. Okay. Now I have to join from A1 to B1, A1 to D1. A1 to D1 is dotted. A1 to B1 is dotted. Again, A1 to A is also dotted. Okay, it's very simple. The same object we have rotated. Okay, we have same object we have rotated. So this is your O1 in bracket and the same point is C1. Okay, and A1 in bracket and O. There's another point which we have forgot here. O to mm-hmm. O1 is your axis. We'll just show that also. Okay, since that's coinciding with your one of the edge, we can just show the axis only at this gap. Okay, this gap can be filled with the axis. I'll just show this as an axis. Here also, this gap will be your axis. From this point to be your axis. Only this gap we can show as your axis. Okay, the top view is done. And finally, we'll complete the front view. How do you do that? First, I'll extend the top, that is A1, B1, C1, D1. Okay, this one, I'll be extending a parallel lines first. Okay, from A1, I extended one line. Again, B1. Okay, from B1, I'll be extending a line. So from the point C, also extend it. Extend from the point C a parallel line. Now, here, listen carefully. I've extended the top, that is A dash, B dash, C dash, and D dash lines are extended parallel to your XY line. Now, what I'm supposed to do is I'm supposed to extend from A, B, C, D, because A, B, C, D is your top. Okay. From the point A, I'll be extending the line until it coincides with the A dash. Okay. You can see the point A is coming from here. Okay. And the point A dash is coming from here. So this will be your point A dash. After that, B. Okay. Point by point, you just extend it so that it coincides. Okay. So the point B is coming from here. And the point B dash is coming from here. This will be a point B dash. Similarly, C. okay, extend it. See, it will be on the same line. Okay, this will be a point C dash. The point C of the top is coming from here. Okay, and C dash is coming from here. Okay, and finally, the point D. Okay, extend the point D. See the point D. The point D is coming from here. The point D dash is coming from here. This will be a point D dash. Okay, and finally O. See, this is the point O. The point O is coming from here, and the point O dash is coming from here. This is a point O dash. Finish the top. Okay, so how will you come to know which one you are supposed to make it thick? Please remember, this was your top. A, B, C, D was the top view. In the top, this A, B, C, D I have rotated in such a way that it will come near the observer. That is A, B, C, D. Whichever the face which is near to the observer, that is A, B, C, D, is visible to the observer. What is A, B, C, D? It is the top. See, it is like this. Okay, in the second condition, it was like this. This A, B, C, D was the top. In the second, third condition, what you did? You rotated like this. Okay, when you rotate like this, A, B, C, D is near to the observer. The same way here, this we are supposed to make it thick. Whichever is near to the observer, that portion will be seen in the front view. Okay, the top is visible to the observer. The similar manner here also, the top will be visible for the observer. So that you mark, make this as thick. So it will be from the point A dash to B dash, B dash to C dash, C dash to D dash, and D dash to A dash. Okay, the top is thick. Now done. Now next, what we'll be doing extending is we'll extend the base. Fine. Already from, we'll start from the point A1 dash. A1 dash will be on the axis. The point A1 dash is coming from here. Okay, and the point A dash. See, this is the A1. Okay, of the base is coming from here. A1 dash is coming from here. So this will be a point A1 dash. After that, B. Extend the line from the point B. So fine. The point B1. Okay, I'm speaking about only the base. The point B1 is coming from here. The point B1 dash is coming from here. This will be your point B1 dash. Coming to the point D1. Okay, the point D1 is coming from here. The point D1 dash is coming from here. So this will be a point D1 dash. C. Okay, so this is your point C1. The point C1 is coming from here. Where is the C1? It is here. So these two will get coincided. So this will be a point C1 dash, which will be in bracket. Okay, now what we will be doing is we will join the longer edges. Which are the longer edges here? B dash to B1 dash. Okay, C dash to C1 dash. D dash to D1 dash. A dash to A1 dash are the longer edges. When I join from B dash to B1 dash, it will be thick. A dash to A1 dash will also be thick. D dash to D1 dash will be thick. Okay, what about C dash to C1 dash? Okay, it will become what? Dotted. The point C dash to C1 dash will be dotted. It is hidden. Fine. The longer edges is over. That is A dash to A1 dash, B dash to B1 dash, C dash to C1 dash, D dash to D1 dash. Okay, what about the base? That is, which is the base? You're supposed to join from A1 dash, B1 dash, C1 dash, and D1 dash. I'll start joining from A1 dash to B1 dash. Again, I'll start joining from A1 dash to D1 dash. Okay? Now, what will happen to the point B1 dash to C1 dash and D1 dash to C1 dash? It will be hidden. Okay, because it is passing inside this parallelogram. Okay, so this will be hidden. Again, from the point D1 dash to C1 dash also will be hidden. And this is your final solution. So